that's, I mean, clearly we know that Mr. Ahern had the opportunity to end the chase, that when he reversed himself off the roadway and Officer Brackney gets his car positioned, gets out of his car, is shouting at Mr. Ahern to put his hands up to get out of the car, that we know that Mr. Ahern went from reverse to forward and evidenced an intent, obviously, to get back out on that road, driving, now we know, drunk and endangering the lives of innocent people. So that's a fact that's just there, that Mr. Ahern tried to get back on the road, and Officer Brackney, under the law, now, under policy, under Bella Vista PD policy, it's different, but under the law, he was justified in ending the threat that Mr. Ahern posed to the public by Mr. Ahern's actions that night. And so that's a factor that we had to consider, is that a jury could easily decide, go along with the law, and decide that he was justified in firing those first five shots. But the problem all along for Officer Brackney has been that last shot. But when you think of everything that he was operating under that night, the high-speed chase, the fact that he was alone out there, the fact that it was at night, the fact that Mr. Ahern, as we know, is a violent person, all those things that we know factor into what's the right thing to do here. Obviously, Officer Brackney committed a crime, and he stepped forward and admitted that, and that's significant to the family, significant to us. And so what do you do with the whole situation when you consider everything? Is it appropriate to send Officer Brackney to prison for his actions that night? I didn't think so. Knowing everything that I know about not only that night, but about Mr. Ahern and his past actions, as well about Officer Brackney's clean record. You know, that's one thing that has not been discussed, but he had no prior problems. In fact, he had a lot of letters of commendation from people in the public that he had assisted. He had gone out of his way to help people at different times, and it's reflected in his file. And so I have to, it's my job, it's my duty to factor everything and not single out just one fact. And there are some damning facts toward Officer Brackney, no doubt about that. But when you consider all the facts, that's why we went forward with this plea. And that's why I think, on reflection, I think most people will come to believe that when you consider everything, that this is appropriate, especially when you consider, too, that that's what Mr. Ahern's family decided was appropriate for them, knowing everything.
One of the things, excuse me, that we were talking about this morning was, do you think Officer Brackney knew about Ahern's past? You know, that was he known in the community? Is he having these problems? You know, do you think that influenced Officer Brackney at all?
You know, Officer Brackney, after he was interviewed, truthfully, it would have been easy for Officer Brackney to come in and say, when that car reversed into the ditch, I recognized it was James Ahern. That would have been the best thing for him to do, quite frankly, because that would have made all of Ahern's past admissible at trial in the first phase, the guilt or innocence phase of trial. But Brackney, to his credit, said, I didn't know it was James Ahern. Now, by doing that, it changed the dynamic of the case, because in the first phase of trial, at least, Ahern's past should legally be excluded. The problem you run into, though, when you have a case of justification, which is the defense they were putting forward, is you're still allowed as the defendant to put on evidence of a person's reputation. And so evidence of James Ahern's reputation in this community would have come forward. I realize that when James Ahern wasn't drinking, he was a pleasant guy. But the problem was there weren't many times when he wasn't drinking, and when he was drinking, he was a menace, quite frankly, to the community, to the public, to police officers who crossed his path, as you saw that night depicted on the video. So you have the legal considerations of, okay,